Don't let your AC system get knocked out by the heat this upcoming summer. Call KS Services and let our team come take a look. We repair and install all makes and models. We even offer a free, no-hassle quote and second opinion, so give us a call today. With our flexible financing, you can literally pick your payment. We may even be able to help you knock down that utility bill a bit.
KS Heating and Air, the team ensuring your comfort.
This is your Weather Xtreme video for Sunday, September the 2nd. I'm meteorologist Brian Peters. Got a lot of weather coming up, it looks like. There's a look at the satellite image this morning. We do have a good deal of clouds over central and south Alabama, the northern part of the state, relatively clear. We can thank a large high-pressure system, both at the surface and aloft, as helping to keep the weather warm and mild across the southeastern U.S. and central Alabama. Unfortunately, we will continue to see isolated showers over the weekend and for today and into the Labor Day part of the weekend as well. Temperatures this morning starting out generally in the 70s once again. We are staying fairly warm. The watch warning map is fairly uncluttered this morning. We do see some green areas up there in Michigan as well as in parts of Nebraska, Kansas, and in Louisiana. Those are all flash flood watches. The QPF, the quantitative precipitation forecast, is suggesting, as we saw yesterday, a couple of areas of fairly significant rainfall on the order of 3 to 5 inches along the front across southwest of the Great Lakes, and then along the Gulf Coast. The Gulf Coast area is associated with a tropical system. We'll talk about that in just a minute. The excessive rainfall outlook includes a moderate risk over parts of Iowa, surrounded by a slight risk that extends from Lake Michigan down into parts of Kansas, and that's for day one. The Storm Prediction Center also features a marginal risk for severe storms over that just about that same area for day one. For day two, the marginal risk is back into the western part of North Dakota, and then for day three, it's over parts of southern Minnesota and a good portion of Wisconsin. All right, the tropics. We mentioned that tropics have become fairly active. We have the area known as Florence. It's moving away from the Cape Verde Islands. And then we have the area that's approaching the Bahamas. That area is still not showing any real good signs, and the conditions are not very favorable for development where it is right now. But it is expected to move across southern Florida and into the Gulf of Mexico, as you can see from the five-day projection. And the National Hurricane Center is suggesting there's a 40 to 60% chance that it could develop. And, of course, we'll see that in the models. In the meantime, Florence is expected to remain a tropical storm, although it has strengthened and showed a little bit of organization overnight. It is still expected to remain a tropical storm and stay well out in the Atlantic. All right, the 06C GFS model run. There's the large high-pressure system at the upper ridge over the mid-Atlantic states, and of course we can see the disturbance over the Bahamas area. And precipitable water values are a little bit shy in the northern and northeastern corner of the state of Alabama, but they're fairly high, over 2 inches, in the southwest corner. That's why we think that the predominant area for showers today is going to be down to the southwest counties. The ridge is still in place on Monday, Labor Day, and precipitable water values stay pretty much the same, although we do see them come up a little bit, but I still think Labor Day isolated showers. The ridge is there, and of course now we see this little disturbance coming across the northern Gulf. And interestingly, yesterday the GFS and the European were quite different. This morning, in this run, there's Tuesday at midday, and it's south of Mobile with a nice rain shield over the Gulf, north-central Gulf of Mexico there, and northwestern Florida. That means we'd probably be in about a 30-40% chance of rain. Here's the European, and the European, in both strength and position, is very, very close. It's always good to see that, because that gives you a confidence and faith in the forecast that you're putting out. By Wednesday, that system is in the lower Mississippi River Valley. We can track it with the upper level disturbance there. And that puts probably a good deal of rain over a good portion of Alabama, depending on exactly how developed the system becomes. But we'll certainly have to watch that and perhaps engage our forecast a little bit higher to its higher probabilities if it indeed does develop, and depending on the exact track. By Thursday, it's up around Memphis and still putting good chances for showers. I'd say at least 40, maybe in the 40 to 60 range over this central Alabama. The system begins to fairly quickly weaken as it's still rotating around that upper ridge on Friday. And then on Saturday, we basically have a hard time finding it as another trough begins to dig in here, coming across through the flow. And then by Sunday, we see that it's kind of an open trough over the lower Mississippi River Valley. So that means probably some chances for showers and thunderstorms as a front comes down with that trough that's moving through the main westerlies so well to our north and northeast. Looking out into Voodoo Country, the GFS is pretty bullish this morning on keeping or producing a nice trough over the eastern part of the country. And that's certainly nice. That's the 13th of September, and that shows that we wouldn't have any excessive heat. And it keeps that trough in various forms, even out through the 16th of September to the end of the period. That'll do it for the Weather Xtreme video this morning. James Spann should be back with the next one first thing on Monday morning, and he'll probably be on a one-a-day schedule since it's a holiday weekend. I hope that you have a great day, and Godspeed.
KS Heating and Air, the team ensuring your comfort.